transistor radio. Though he turned in his bones 20 years ago.
We've made it to Prairie Island Campground in Minnesota. It's our first time in Minnesota, and right there is the Mississippi River, right by our camper. So we're getting to camp on the Mississippi River, which is really cool. And now we're gonna walk around the campground a little bit, explore it, see what the shower houses are like, because there's no sewer hookups here, but we do have water.
We have water,
which is awesome, huge upgrade. Oh, we have potentially a big upgrade in the camper. We walked into a T-Mobile store, and I've been struggling with internet on this entire trip, trying to work out of the RV is oftentimes exciting because you're constantly searching for which cell phone is going to work as a hotspot today. And we got an official T-Mobile hotspot.
Home internet.
So T-Mobile home internet. And with Rebecca's cell phone plan, it's supposed to be $30 a month.
At the most, it'd be 50
a month. No limits. True home internet. We're going to try it in the RV to see how that will work for working.
For being able to work.
For being able to actually work.
Which is important.
It's a pretty big deal, since the whole point of the journey is to explore the country but also work from the RV
in this territory that you're doing right now,
in this territory in the Midwest. Initial tests make me think that there's still some more analysis to do. It's got a good connection right now, but my speed test was 9 down and 0.5 up, which it keeps switching from 4G to 5G, and really 5G is my nemesis. If it goes to 5G really anywhere, it's honestly just trash. I wish I could just disable 5G. We're here on the Mississippi up here in Minnesota, and since we're right beside it and there's a little beach the campground has so generously made for us, we've got to get into this water. It's not cold, allegedly. We'll find out. And?
Not cold.
Well, let's find out if it's cold to dad. It's not bad. It's not as warm as, say,
hot tub.
The Tennessee River down in Alabama. But we are in Minnesota. Yeah, we got to get in this water. Got to. Right?
Yeah, you get to, you got to.
Got to. Just regular life is happening out here in the RV. We just lost a tooth. We lost a tooth.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Right here. It literally just got lost. I asked, is it loose enough? And it just kind of popped out.
Just like, boop. Yeah. Ah! Oh, man. It's crazy. Hopefully, can you see all that? This is how I spend most of my days working outside, and I'm happy to report the T-Mobile hotspot handled everybody's internet inside, and I was able to use a separate hotspot for my work outside, and my calls went great today. Can you tell us where we are?
Stockholm Pie Shop and General Store. Yes.
And we have, what kind of pie did you get, Gabriel?
Bumbleberry.
Some kind of apple. Scandinavian apple, I think.
Stockholm apple.
Cocoa choco nut. Yes.
And I also got bumbleberry with ice cream, and we've heard word on the internet that this is the best pie in the world, in the country. And we've had some really good pie, so we're gonna put it to the test. Two thumbs up from Libby.
Two thumbs up from Rebecca.
25,000 Michelin stars.
25,000 Michelin stars.
Same goes for me.
That was really good pie. It's definitely the best pie of this trip, without a doubt. We're here in Pepin, Wisconsin, visiting a museum for Laura Ingalls Wilder, which is an American author of a lot of books that Rebecca and the kids really enjoyed reading when they were little. We liked reading On the Banks of Plum Creek and Little House in the Big Woods.
And Little House on the Prairie.
And Little House on the Prairie. And the Little House in the Big Woods is right here in Pepin, Wisconsin. We're going to go see a recreation of the actual cabin. Not the exact location, but near the exact location in the same town.
Because
the Big Woods no longer exist, as Gabriel pointed out.
Just call me Ma.
Okay, Ma.
Oh, you got your things. It's time for us to go. So I grab my bag.
We've made it all the way outside Pepin, Wisconsin. And right behind me is the little house. The little house in the big woods, featured in the novel. It's pretty cool to see. Knock, knock.
Hi. All right, can I take your picture,
love? All five slept in there. That was a tight bedroom with five people.
I thought she slept in the attic.
Well, I'm just telling you what it says right there.
Yeah.
It's pretty little. It said a little house.
Yep.
In the big woods.
Well, that's
not fun. Oh no.
Not fun.
Yeah, some kind of a situation. I mean, this would be faced by the people at the time. Also, the fact that you can see the outside from the inside through the wall would be a problem.
This replica was built in 1978, so it's my age.
Yeah. Today is the day we leave Winona, Minnesota, and we've really enjoyed it. We've only been here for
two nights, one whole day.
Oh, I'm getting to get some help from a camera person. Okay.
It's me, Libby.
So we loved it. It was described by a local who also happens to be from Atlanta, but he grew up in Winona. He said it's known as the Miami of Minnesota. Maybe. We really enjoyed it. It's on a little island, basically, in the Upper Mississippi River. And we've gone to see Laura Ingalls Wilder's house, the little cabin in the Big Woods.
Where she was born.
They were not Big Woods because the trees have gotten chopped, but they were Big Woods.
And then we hung out in the town. We had some pie. The town is gorgeous. It has a bike path and running path around a couple of lakes. It really is the land of 10,000 lakes here in Minnesota. And we were corrected, it's actually over 14,000 lakes. So there are a lot of lakes here in Minnesota.
And the radio, and I headed on the road. I said, I'm ready for what I'm about to see. Yeah.
We pulled off the road for a second to grab some lunch in Owatonna, Minnesota. I think that's how you say it. And they have a little village they call it the village of yesteryear, and they have old buildings that they've collected from around their town and created a little like diorama that you can come and visit. And this is a totally unexpected find on just a random lunch spot. We needed basically our requirements were we need a large parking lot that we can pull over and make sandwiches in. And this is what we kind of stumbled upon.
And the cobbler.
Yeah.
Worth it anyway.
Wow, well,
We kind of crashed a tour.
We crashed a tour.
By invitation
of the Owatonna
Historical
Society. And we went to see
the village of yesteryear.
And most impressive, we saw that house right behind us, the Donnell House. And it was built by the only senator ever from Owatonna. And
U.S. Senator.
Yeah. And it was absolutely gorgeous inside.
And you could walk through everything. It wasn't roped off.
Nope. You could walk through everything and see everything. And they had all kinds of cool stuff in there.
We crashed the tour was going into that house. And it was really cool.
Wow. As we continue our tour through Owatonna on this 30-minute/3-hour lunch stop, we just went inside of the little historical building and we found out that it is the hometown of Cloud Cult.
And Owl City.
I mean, it's blowing our mind.
And a fashion designer
who made one of Beyonce's iconic,
a few of
Beyonce's iconic outfits. So they have a wealth of culture here. It is the greatest 30-minute, 3-hour lunch stop that we've had so far on this journey.
We headed north till rain had turned to snow. Through rusty towns and dusty gravel road. And I said, Grandpa, where is this thing you wanted to show me? He said, kid, you got a long way to go.
We're at the Laura Ingalls Wilder Museum in, I don't know what this town is called.
Hold on. It'll come to us. Walnut Grove.
There was a shirt right there.
There's a shirt right in front of us.
We're going to go see the Plum Creek House.
On the banks of Plum Creek, the little dugout house along the banks of Plum Creek.
Mm-hmm.
And first, we're going to go see the museum in town. And then later tonight, we're coming back for a Laura Ingalls Wilder pageant.
And Libby has a dress for it.
She is going to look like Laura.
Fresh or canned?
Canned, I think. Canned corn, please.
How many?
I think I'll have 2 cans.
He's not letting me get anything. Ask him. What else?
That's right. We don't know how to work the price machine.
It's not a cash register.
Yeah, the price machine.
All right, Lib, what are we going to do?
We're going to go somewhere, Laura Lake,
that is fed by Plum Creek. So we are swimming on the banks of Plum Creek. We're going to count it. Got done swimming in Laura's lake, and there's a little mulberry tree that has some delicious mulberries on it. So now I'm getting to do one of my favorite things, which is foraging for food in the wild, much to my family's dismay.
Well,
I'm glad we got into Laura's lake, because swimming in Plum Creek is not gonna happen.
It's a little river right now.
It's a little river.
It literally says when you enter, be careful of deep and fast moving waters. Laura almost drowned.
Yeah, it's in
her book, so.
And so we didn't attempt it. We did see the dugout. Which is really just a depression in a farmer's field now. And now we're gonna go back and take a break before the pageant.
You will see me in the Prairie. Get up.
The pageant.
Hey, Libby Ingalls Wilder, where are we going?
To the Ingalls Wilder Pageant.
To where now?
The Laura Ingalls Wilder Pageant.
Transistor radio, yet I keep going to where it seems I'm meant to go. And I finally realized what he wanted to show me
where I've been. Live from Lamberton, Minnesota.
Lamberton, Minnesota.
The cornfields of.
The cornfields of. We've camped now for 2 full days. Right beside a gigantic cornfield.
And there is a pig pen.
There's
somewhere in this vicinity. I can't see it.
But
it's here.
It makes its presence known every once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
And last night we got to see, hold on, car passing. Wind blowing. We're pausing the production for a second. Yesterday we spent the day exploring the footsteps of Laura Ingalls Wilder on the banks of Plum Creek.
Well, we were in the Walnut Grove, Minnesota area, which her family lived in this area a couple of different times. I'd say a total of maybe 5 years,
yeah,
spread out over a little bit more time, or maybe even less time than that, really. But this is the place where the 1980s television series was set, was in Walnut Grove, Minnesota.
Yeah, so this is
so this is what a lot of people think of, I think, when they think of
Little House on the Prairie. And it looked like Little House on the Prairie.
Yeah. The town is very small. I think it's population of 800 or something.
Very little.
Like that. And they do a pageant, which is basically a play, during the weekends of July every year. And so we got tickets and we went to see that. We went to the Laura Ingalls Museum. And we went down to Plum Creek, which was the setting of one of her books on the banks of Plum Creek, where they lived in a dugout house. So we got to see where the dugout house was, although of course that is not there anymore. But I thought it was good. It was
a home-spun production that had very high production value with moving, yeah, sets, and there was fire at one point. There were live animals.
They did not allow videography.
So I got a couple of little, really short clips to just give you an idea of what the wind. If the wind's shaking the microphone, it can't be great for the sound. This is going to be a tough drive day.
Yeah. They've been doing the production since 1978, so this is its 45th year.
They've had 45 years to really hone the production to a science, and
yeah,
they do have it down to a science. And the amphitheater's beautiful. It's under the stars. It got cool at,
yeah,
night, which was great.
And Libby
had, dressed.
Had gotten a Prairie Girl outfit at one of the
she
museums
looked,
that we went to, so she was very pleased.
A and lot she of looked like
girls,
a character.
A lot of little girls dressed up in their Laura,
yeah,
type outfits. It was cute.
It was a wonderful Americana day celebrating one of America's greatest authors.